I am shredding the potatoes. You buy the less potatoes, box grater. I use the bigger circle side. You can buy the potatoes shredded in the freezer section of your grocery store. Trader Joe's has it. And use those. I feel like they hold a lot of water. So I like to do my own potato, just peeled on the box grater. We're gonna do this. We're doing 4 potatoes for this recipe.
Time to get our hands dirty. I shredded all the potato, added our eggs, the flour, salt and pepper, and now we're gonna get this. I'm just gonna crack the eggs first with my hands to start working in there. And we're gonna start mixing this together. I'm gonna let it rest though for a little bit before we fry them up. And I'm gonna actually use a skillet, an electric skillet, to cook them because it'll be a lot more consistent and it's a flat surface. So let's get it dirty, start cooking. In the bowl, I have the mixture now, so my hands are dirty, we're gonna go hands-free. What I'm gonna do is I want it to rest. You don't want the potatoes turning brown, so put a wet paper towel, damp, on top. Same thing like if you make guacamole. First of all, we make guacamole. Save the pit from the avocado and put that in your guacamole and cover with a damp paper towel and it won't turn brown on you. Apple slices, you can put them in a Ziploc baggie. Squeeze a little bit of fresh lemon juice on the paper towel. Get it damp and wrap your apples, put in a Ziploc baggie, your apples won't turn brown. So little tricks like that can help save your food and make it last a little bit longer. Because at the end of the day here, working mom, every dollar counts, get the best bang for your buck. Get ready to do the latkes. So most people have this in their house. It is, I call it my pancake maker. It is just a flat griddle. And if you see now how I explained about the wet paper towels earlier, we're gonna take it off and see how the potatoes did not brown. So I'm gonna get a spoon and we will start making latkes.
The other day we fried those risotto cakes and like I was saying, you don't want to waste the oil. They put in a quart container, so you get a strainer because we're gonna fry our latkes up and you just strain your oil. You have clean oil to use again. I know oil's not expensive, but why spend the money when you don't have to? Oil's hot in the pan. I use the large skillet because it has a bigger surface area to be working. And this is our latke mix. Now see how it didn't turn brown? So what I'm doing is using a 2-spoon method, and if you want the substance to come off of the spoon, slowly dip the spoon into the oil, it'll start to fry, and you can scoop it and push it with the other spoon, and it won't stick to the bottom. Also, once the oil starts to fry around it, they'll start to float, and you'll have a little spatula, and you can flip them to be golden brown. Oil is right around 350 right now, and once you get it up high, what you want to do is lower it so that they don't end up burning and your oil stays nice and consistent and clean throughout the whole frying process. Don't overcrowd your fryer. I'm probably going to put around like 8 latkes in here because this is a large fryer, large something there.
That's the color you're looking for. And because we did use our own raw potatoes, I'm going to flip these quite a few times. I like to keep it moving, so these are a little pale right now. But I have the oil at 350 because it's raw potato. You want to cook it fully through. You don't want, no one likes raw potato. And it's like making homemade french fries. It's going to take a while to cook. So keep your oil at a consistent 350. Constantly keep moving these. I use one of these. It's an offset spatula. You could use another spoon. You can use a set of tongs. I just like this tool. It's nice and light. We are in latke heaven right now. So I'm just taking my offsets back and loosening the bottoms and then so we can flip them. But we have a bunch done already. I've already eaten two, so I can tell you, they're delicious. So when they're coming out, they're going on a paper towel and I have salt right next to it. And I'm just putting a little bit of salt on each side. This is something that if you're gonna do, you need to be near it. You don't want to walk away too far because of the fact that you don't want to overcook them and constantly want them to keep moving.